stable outlook on the personal line segment is really a function of lower cat activity as compared to 2017 and 2018, where we saw above average losses. So for 2019, we see lower levels of losses in the homeowner segment. It is important to note, however, that this is not a function of just lucky weather patterns. Management teams have definitely been proactive in terms of more underwriting actions, better predictive analytics, better concentration management in terms of geographic and product line concentration. These types of actions will definitely benefit results longer term. The stable outlook on the personal lines is also a function of better loss cost trends in the private passenger auto. And here we see more active rate adequacy, and some of the deterioration we saw in earlier years has definitely been adjusted through significant rate activity for those carriers. Lastly, the stable outlook also is a function of strong risk-adjusted capitalization. We did see the downturn in December of 2018. We saw a quick rebound in 2019 in terms of the equity markets. And those companies that were really able to hold firm and had sufficient liquidity could withstand above average cat activity and saw strength in capitalization. So here, between the underwriting profitability, unrealized capital gains, as well as just strong investment performance, we do see all-time highs in terms of surplus for 2019. In the near to midterm for the personal lines, we do see some pressures. First of all, reinsurance pricing is expected to continue to increase, especially for those in loss-affected areas. Earlier, we didn't see the response from reinsurers, and I think that was a function of the abundance of capacity. But now we are seeing them better monitoring their own concentrations, and we're seeing that through rate increases as well as tighter terms and conditions. So for this segment in particular, we've seen a lot of creative structures where there is more protection on both vertical and horizontal levels, and what this is trying to do is really lower both frequency and severity. So in the cases where companies are pressured in terms of pricing for reinsurance, this could have a negative impact on both operating performance and balance sheet should those reinsurance structures not be available in the same cost-effective manner that they had been. In terms of auto, we are seeing still the concern over severity. This is not, alleviating. We still have distracted driving. We still have more miles driven, but now we also have the legalization of cannabis on the horizon, and we're really not sure what that may also have on the impact on frequency. We are seeing carriers being more proactive just in terms of what they're doing with predictive analytics, better technology, better innovation, in terms of actually applying analytics to get the right price. And we are seeing also more proactive things, both on the loss prevention side as well as the claim settlement side. So in terms of homeowners, we are seeing InsurTech devices in homes being pushed. So for water losses, which are also an ongoing concern, this may help prevent losses with respect to the ability of homeowners to either be alerted or have water systems shut off automatically. There are, a delay in terms of what the benefit of this will be, as well as how to price for this. InsurTech in the auto is also continuing to gain traction, and here we do think while this may increase costs and expenses in the near term, the beneficial impact over the longer term will definitely benefit the segment. But overall, the stable outlook, we do expect carriers to act diligently. They'll be able to face challenges, both what's known as well as emerging, and with the increased use of predictive analytics, technology, innovative solutions will definitely help them face market challenges as well as changing customer demands.